Hey YouTube, I'm back once again, back with some more pickups. Pretty much what I've got is over the last few days. It's Tuesday morning. A chunk of these I got yesterday morning, and then the rest, bar one, I got from the charity shops on Friday. I did order one thing off Amazon last week. Which is the first thing I'm going to show. Now, I got this on DVD recently, and it was in one of my last pickups videos, and a few people commented. I commented in the video that I wondered whether there was a Blu-ray release, and I'd looked on CEX, and they only seemed to have an ex-rental edition. So we've got Paul Blart Mall Cop. I found this on, well, I didn't find this, it was on Amazon, and there's me showing that in the video. A couple of people actually contacted me and said, you know, Amazon have it for sale. So I had a look on there. I found this for £1 plus postage, so it was less than £2.20. And I was very surprised when it arrived with a slipcover and with a digital copy as well, which redeemed fine. I've already put my DVD disc inside as well, so I've made it into a double one. But when, like I said, when I looked on CEX for this, I did a search, and it only came up as an ex-rental. So I've got, I was going to say, no, really? Literally 2 minutes ago I did this on here, and it's now wanting to do an update. I can't believe that. Right, I'm going to pause for a minute. Okay, and I'm back. Right, so what I did when I was looking, I literally just did a Paul Blart search. Then, can we see that? Filtered it into Blu-rays, and then we've got Paul Blart, Paul Blart budget version. Come on, focus. There's another Paul Blart. I don't know why there's two copies at the same price, but then you've got Paul Blart 2 budget version, and that's it. There are no more results. And that Paul Blart 2 is £1. Budget version, as far as CX concerned, is a rental copy. But there's no other copies of Paul Blart 2, no, you know, sell-through copies, which is what this one is. But then when this came, if you actually scan the barcode, it's there, and it's not the budget version. This one's £2.50. So CEX have it on their website, but it doesn't come up in the search, which makes me wonder how many other products have they got available that you can't find in the search. It's a curious one. It just it baffled me on why that happened. But yeah, mine was still cheaper than CX does. I actually did have a look to see what was in stock. Oh, this keeps going out of focus. And the nearest one to me is in Oldham, which is a good distance away. So yeah, I think I did all right with that for what, just over £2. I watched it the weekend. So last week I watched Paul Blart 1, or re-watched Paul Blart 1 last week, which I really enjoyed. I remembered very little about it. There was only a couple of little things that I remembered. Yeah, I had a lot of fun with that. And then when this came on, was it Friday or Saturday? I'm not sure. I think it came on Friday, but I watched it on Saturday night. it wasn't quite as good as the first one, but it was still a lot of fun. Yeah, I enjoyed it. So that one was from Amazon, and the rest of these, for this first bunch at least, I got on Friday from the charity shops. I'm just wondering if I've got these sorted out. I don't think that I have. I probably should have maybe got them into a decent order before I started, but never mind. So this one came from British Red Cross. No, it didn't. Sue Ryder's. These next couple came from Sue Ryder's. So for £1, I got the complete 11th season of South Park. So I was happy to find that. Also from Sue Ryder's, again for £1, I got the complete series 1-4 of Skins. I've seen all of the first series. I think I've seen most of the second series, but hardly anything of series 3. I don't think I've seen any of series 4. To be fair, I don't think I know they changed the cast for the third series for the most part. I didn't think it was quite as good, but yeah, to get the whole lot for £1, I'll have a revisit of that. Then I've just got to figure out what else came from where, because I'm pretty sure I got some more from here. Yeah, so these three were part of the 3 for £1 deal that they do. So the way it goes is it's 3 for £1 on DVDs, excluding any Blu-rays and or DVD or Blu-ray box sets. So these were part of the 3 for £1. They're all Scooby-Doo as well, that I didn't own. So we've got a 2-pack of Scooby-Doo movies there, which are Movie Monsters and A Magic Mummy. Scooby-Doo Pirates Ahoy. And Scooby-Doo Legend of the Pantasaur. So yeah, chuffed that I've found so many new Scooby-Doo films that I didn't actually have, and they were £1 for all three. Then this lot all came from British Red Cross, which they do also, no, they don't do 3 for £1, they do buy 2 get 1 free. So these were all £1, but excuse me, but the buy 2 get 1 free, so in the end they cost me £4. I think they cost me £4. At first when I got to the till, the girl says, oh, these are buy 1 get 1 free. I'm thinking result, but then she realized she'd made a mistake and said, oh no, it's buy 2 get 1 free. So the only Blu-ray I got was Public Enemies. I got another series of Spooks, this one being series 3, so that's another one to add to the list, or remove from the list, should I say. I don't know exactly how many seasons of series of Spooks that they did. I know it went on for quite a while. There was a spin-off one that I saw, complete third series of Dad's Army. Some Mitchell and Webb, the two faces of Mitchell and Webb. I've been listening to them in the car. I've got some BBC radio play CDs of theirs. It's really, really funny. So yeah, I grabbed that. And then Stargate Atlantis, I got 2 volumes, season 5 volumes 4 and 5. I never see series 5. Stargate Atlantis is out in the wild, and I only had one. I've got all of series 1-4 and only 1 volume of series 5. So now I think I only need 2 more to complete the set. So chuffed about that. So yeah, they all came as buy 2 get 1 free. So it was basically £4 for all of those. And that was everything I got on Friday. And I went back out yesterday, not expecting much, because I was literally going around the same shops that I did on Friday. But over most recent weeks, if not months, I haven't done too badly on a Monday morning going around the charity shops. So I went out, like I say, and I did get some stuff, a bunch for me and a few bits for trade as well. So from Salvation Army, their DVDs, excluding the box sets, are 45 pence each. So 45 pence, Patient Z, The Infected. This is a 101 films release. Never heard of it, but just like the look of the cover. Wishmaster 3, Devil's Stone. I don't own any others of these, at least that I'm aware of, on DVD, Blu-ray, or even VHS for that matter. So yeah, I'll have to look out for some of the others. I think that's another series where there's a hell of a lot of movies. These two I got for trade-ins. I'm a little disappointed that the trading's gone back down again, but still making a bit of profit on them. So we've got Phoenix Knights series 1 and 2, again for 45p. Series 1 I think trading at 150 now, and 120 for series 2. For a good while these have gone back up. Last year CEX really dumped all their DVD trading prices almost down to nothing, and these were amongst them. But a few titles did start to go back up as far as trading value was concerned, even though when they took down all the trading values, the actual what they sell them for didn't change for the most part. And these did go back up to about a fiver trading not too long ago, and then settled at about £2 each. And that was the last time I looked. So when I saw these, I thought, oh yeah, I'll have £2 trading each of those. But I scanned them in the store just to make sure. And that's when I realised that both had gone down. But still enough to make a bit of money out of them. And then this one, a series that I've never ever seen and was never really that interested in, to be honest. It's Cad Fael. This is the complete collection, series 1 to 4. Cost me £3. And it trades in for 5. That's not going to zoom in. There it is. Yeah, it trades in for 5. So between those three, there's like almost £8 in trade value. So I'm happy about that. Cost me less than a fiver for the lot, including the ones I'm keeping. Then back to Sue Riders. I got another 3 DVDs for £1. So this is a Region 1 US release of From Hell, Director's Limited Edition. I don't know if it's a different cut of the movie, and it's difficult to tell with UK over American releases because of the different frame rates. The films, the exact same movies, are different lengths. So I don't know if this is an actual director's cut or if it's just the same movie but with a bunch of different extras. But it's a good film. I do enjoy that one. I also got, as part of the 3 for £1, Snapper of the Lost Boys. So I was chuffed to have found that one. A film that I still need to re-watch. I haven't seen this, I think, since 1988 or 1989. Didn't enjoy it that much back then. But yeah, I definitely need to re-watch it because it's a highly loved film from what I can gather. A lot of people really like it. Then this is a weird one. So we've got two movie set of The Rocky Horror Picture Show and Shock Treatment. If you do a search for this on CEX, if I quickly have a look, see if I can do that. So, like I say, if you do a search for this on CEX, you get 2 results. So I literally just did a search for Rocky Horror Shock to get both movies. You get 2 results. This is not gonna... There we go. So one sells for £2 and trades in for 10p. The other sells for £10 and trades in for £5. But they look to be exactly the same. Now, in the store, because they put their sticker over the barcode, so I had to pull the sleeve out to scan it. And when I scanned it, there was no results. So it doesn't actually bring up either one of these two as the as what this release is. So if I take this into CEX, which I wasn't going to, well, I thought about it when I saw it, but if I was to take that into CEX, they would scan it. They'd come up with no results. They'd do their search, find these two. Now, which one of those two do you think they're going to give you the trading value for? I very doubt, very much doubt it'll be that one. They're going to give me 10p. So yeah, I'm going to keep that. I haven't got the Rocky Horror Picture Show at all, actually, on even on Blu-ray or DVD. So I've got Shock Treatment on Blu-ray. So yeah, I'm going to keep that one. And then finally, from Sue Riders, found another Blu-ray. This one a Steelbook, but it's a movie that I don't have at all, so I'm actually going to keep this one for the time being, at least. This is The Wolfman, a movie that I think was quite critically hated when it came out. I didn't mind it, I thought it was okay. You got Anthony Hopkins, Benicio del Toro, and Emily Blunt. I'd forgotten Emily Blunt was in it, and Hugo Weaving. So it's a great cast, but I didn't think it was that awful of a movie. I mean, I didn't even think it was a bad movie, to be fair. It's a bit of a boring steelbook, because nothing on the inside. You can see there's a little bit of a dent on the front, but that's fine. It was a quid. Then finally, from Cash Converters, it's been a few weeks since I found any Blu-rays in there. They've just had nothing new on the shelf, and they had quite a few that I didn't own. But I also saw a couple of snapper cases. One that I was positive, I've seen this one in there many, many times. Batman. Tim Burton's 89 Batman. This one being a snapper. Now, I was convinced that I had this, so every time I've just passed over it. And I was looking through them the other day. I had them in a couple of boxes, and I was looking through them earlier in the week. And I've actually got them back out on the shelf now. Now I've found some space for them. Oh, they're way up at the top there. But it turns out I owned Batman Returns and Batman and Robin, but not this one. So I still don't have Batman Forever for the set. But yeah, for 50p, which is weird, because not too long ago all their DVDs were 20p. But it looks like they put them back up again. Still, for 50p, it's not mint, but it's not far off. It's in very good condition. Then a bunch of Blu-rays they didn't have. So I got Charlie St. Cloud. Don't know anything about that one. Mr. Popper's Penguins. These were all 49p. I saw this on the shelf and I thought, ooh, Christine, we'll have that. Yeah, it's not that Christine. It's something I've never heard of. Yeah, I thought it was Stephen King's Christine, but never mind, still 49p. The Lost World Jurassic Park. I've got the other two. I did have the big sleeve I mentioned before. I saw that a few months ago. So getting them back as normal releases. I didn't have this one. The only difference is it kind of tingles my OCD a little, because either two have got the digital copy, so the artwork's slightly different with the blue bar across the top there. So this one isn't quite going to match on the shelf, but like I say, for 49p it'll do for now, until I find a replacement. This was another one that excited me for about 20 seconds until I picked it up. Footloose. Unfortunately, it's not the original, it's the remake, but I've never seen this, so I do like the original, so I'll give that a try. I got the first one of these a while back, so now I've got the second one, so now I've got the first one, Pitch Perfect. It's supposed to be a decent movie. And then this is another one that's, it looks like another chick flick. I don't know that much about it. Safe Haven, safe haven, should I say. And 49p. So there we go. That's it. That's everything I've picked up pretty much over the last not even 7 days. But yeah, I suppose if you include that one, that came middle of last week. So I probably ordered it last Sunday or Monday, maybe. Not sure. But I ordered it early last week. Must have been Monday or Tuesday actually, because I think that video went up on Monday. So yeah, like I say, that's everything. I don't know how long this video is because I've stopped a couple of times and restarted. So what I'm looking at the moment is 6 minutes, but that's 6 minutes since I last stopped to check Rocky Horror on CEX. So I don't think this is going to be quite as long as last week's video. Just looking at the clock, I reckon I've been going less than half an hour since I started, and like I say, I've stopped a couple of times. So yeah, anyway, I'll put this all together in a little edit, and whatever happens, it'll probably go up as one video. Anyway, I'm wittering on and just making this video even longer. So as usual, if you've managed to get this far, just put a little message in the comments below just to say you got to the end. I'd just like to see how many people actually do get to the end. Makes me feel a little better, because sometimes when you look at the analytics and you see a 20 or 30 minute video, and sometimes the retention is only like 5 or 6 minutes, and it makes me think, you know, how are people only getting 5 or 6 minutes in? You know, I know I'm not the most enthralling person to listen to, but surely if you're gonna switch off, you're gonna switch off almost immediately. But then I think that when I go into a video just to look at the comments, it automatically starts the video. So then I've got to pause it just so I can go down and start reading comments. So does the system register that as somebody who's literally watched 2 seconds of the video, which then brings the average watch time down? And if everybody who's looking at the comments that happens to, does that bring the watch time down? I don't know. Maybe it does. But anyway, it's just nice to know people are getting to the end of the videos. Anyway, I'm going this time. Thank you very much for watching. And I will catch you, I don't know when, actually. I need to save a bit of money because I've pre-ordered 3 items. I think one's early November, but two fairly expensive items coming out next month. So I need to put a little bit of money away, a little bit of money aside to pay for those. So the next few weeks, maybe a little, not that I'm buying that much, but buying stuff online, I won't be doing much of that. It'll be more of stuff like this. I mean, if I can find stuff like this, then that's probably not a problem. But I don't see myself going out again this week until Friday, because I'm off on Friday. So maybe I'll have a look after the weekend. Anyway, I'm wittering on. That 6 minutes that was on this clock has now gone up to almost 10. So this video is getting longer and longer and longer. So yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks very much for watching. And I will catch you next time. Ciao.